Hello students and welcome to your English language class. Today in this class we'll be reading this poem once and we'll be doing the question answers and book exercise, okay, of this poem. So let us just read the poem once. You've read of several kinds of cat and my opinion now is that you should need no interpreter to understand their character. You now have learnt enough to see that cats are much like you and me. And other people whom we find possessed of various types of mind. For some are sane and some are mad, and some are good and some are bad, and some are better, some are worse, but all may be described in verse. You've seen them both at work and games, and learnt about their proper names, their habits and their habitat. But how would you address a cat? So first, your memory I'll jog and say, a cat is not a dog. Now dogs pretend they like to fight, they often bark, more seldom bite. But yet a dog is, on the whole, what you would call a simple soul. Of course, I'm not including peaks and such fantastic canine freaks. The usual dog about the town is much inclined to play the clown. And far from showing too much pride, is frequently undignified. He's very easily taken in, just chuck him underneath the chin, or slap his back or shake his paw, and he will gamble or guffaw. He's such an easygoing lout, he'll answer any hail or shout. Again, I must remind you that a dog's a dog, a cat's a cat. With cats, some say, one rule is true, don't speak till you are spoken to. Myself, I do not hold with that, I say you should address a cat. But always keep in mind that he resents familiarity. I bow and, taking off my hat, address him in this form, O cat. But if he is the cat next door, whom I have often met before, that means he comes to see me in my flat. I greet him with an oops, our cat. I've heard them call him James Buzz James, but we've not got so far as names. Before a cat will condescend, to treat you as a trusted friend, some little token of esteem is needed, like a dish of cream. A cat's entitled to expect these evidences of respect, and so in time you reach your aim, and finally call him by his name. So this is this, and that is that, and there's how you address a cat. So, this is your poem, and it's written by T.S. Eliot. Now today, we'll be doing the question answers. Okay, given in your book. So first question is, how does the poet describe a dog? So to this question, what should be your answer? The poet describes a dog as a simple soul who pretends that he likes to fight. It often barks but seldom bites. Okay, so let me just repeat the answer. The poet describes a dog as a simple soul. You know the spelling of soul? S-O-U-L, soul. So the poet describes a dog as a simple soul who pretends that he likes to fight. It often barks but seldom bites. Now this is your second question. Which rule relating to cats does the poet disagree with? Wo aisa kaun sa rule hai cats ke baare mein jisse poet agree nahi karta hai? Theek hai? तो अगर आप पोयम में देखोगे तो उसमें ये लाइन लिखी हुई है दैट विद कैट सम से वन रूल इज ट्रू डोंट स्पीक टिल यू आर स्पोकन टू. सो इसका आंसर हम ऐसे लिखेंगे, द पोएट डिसअग्रीज विद द रूल रिलेटिंग टू कैट्स दैट डू नॉट स्पीक टिल यू आर स्पोकन टू, विच मीन्स डू नॉट बी द फर्स्ट वन टू स्टार्ट द कॉन्वर्सेशन विद अ कैट. ओके, इसका मतलब है कि हमें कैट से जब भी हम कॉन्वर्सेशन, या अगर कोई कैट आपके आसपास है, सो डू नॉट बी द फर्स्ट वन टू स्टार्ट द कॉन्वर्सेशन. हमें अपनी तरफ से पहल नहीं करनी चाहिए कि हम उससे बातचीत करना शुरू करें. ओके, लेट हर अप्रोच अस या लेट हिम अप्रोच अस, देन ओनली यू स्पीक टू द कैट, अदरवाइज लेट इट बी. ओके, और एल्स इट विल फील ऑफेंडेड. सो इसका आंसर आप लिखेंगे, the poet disagrees with the rule relating to cats that do not speak until you are spoken to, which means do not be the first one to start the conversation with a cat. So this is your answer to the second question. And then here we have the third question. What thing should one keep in mind regarding cats? So cats ke bare mein aisi kaun si cheez hai jo hamesha hame dhyan mein rakhni chahiye? Aap poem mein dekhiye, isme jo stanza hai usme ye diya hua hai that page number 61, first stanza. Okay. Myself, I do not hold with that. I say you should address a cat, but always keep in mind that he resents familiarity. Okay, तो इसका आंसर हम कैसे लिखेंगे? The one thing that one should keep in mind regarding cats is that they resent familiarity, which means they dislike friendly behavior from strangers. कि उन्हें strangers से अगर लगता है कि कोई stranger उनके साथ बहुत ज़्यादा friendly behave कर रहा है या उसके बहुत नज़दीक आ रहा है तो वो चीज़ उसको पसंद नहीं आती है cat को. Okay. So, इसका आंसर लिखना है द वन थिंग दैट वन शुड कीप इन माइंड रिगार्डिंग कैट्स इज दैट दे रिजेंट फैमिलैरिटी विच मीन्स दे डिसलाइक फ्रेंडली बिहेवियर फ्रॉम स्ट्रेंजर्स एंड द लास्ट क्वेश्चन इज हाउ शुड वन एड्रेस अ कैट बिफोर वन कैन फाइनली कॉल हिम बाय हिज नेम सो टू दिस यू विल आंसर वन शुड एड्रेस अ कैट बाय गिविंग सम टोकन ऑफ रिस्पेक्ट टू विन हिज ट्रस्ट लाइक अ डिश ऑफ क्रीम before one can finally call a cat by his name. Okay, so ek cat ko uske naam se bulane se pehle hame kya karna chahiye, hame usko kuch gift dena chahiye, kuch token of respect hame usko dena chahiye aur taki hum uska trust jeet sake. Theek hai, tabhi wo aapke upar bharosa kar payegi ek cat, otherwise wo tumhe harm kar sakti hai. So one should address a cat by giving some token of respect to win his trust, like a dish of cream or something, before one can finally call a cat by his name. So this is the answer to this question. Now in word power we have cats and dogs are the most common pets people have, and there are dog lovers and cat lovers who will argue over which pet is better. How would you describe the pets? ओके कुछ लोग जो हैं कैट लवर्स होते हैं, कुछ डॉग लवर्स होते हैं, और उन्हें लगता है कि कैट्स आर बेटर और कुछ को लगता है डॉग्स आर बेटर. तो यहाँ पे कुछ क्वालिटीज़ हैं जो मेंशन की हुई हैं जो कि आपको लगता है कि एक डॉग के अंदर ये क्वालिटी है तो आप उसके आगे डी लिख सकते हो, एंड इफ़ यू थिंक दिस क्वालिटी इज़ विद अ कैट और अ कैट पोजेसेस दिस क्वालिटी देन यू कैन राइट सी इन फ्रंट ऑफ इट. और अगर ऐसी कोई क्वालिटी है दैट बोथ कैन हैव देन यू कैन राइट डी सी. ओके लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल इन माय ओपिनियन अ डॉग इज़ मोर फ्रेंडली देन अ कैट, सो इन फ्रंट ऑफ फ्रेंडली आई हैव रिटन डी. ओके सो फ्रेंडली डी, ईगर टू प्लीज डी, क्वाइट सी, दैट्स अ कैट, कैट इज़ क्वाइट राइट एंड डॉग्स आर ऑलवेज बार्किंग, रिलैक्स्ड डॉग, dignified DC, both are dignified, formal, I think cats are more formal so I have written C, happy dog, calm cat, enthusiastic dog, loyal, both you can write both DC, loving both DC, obedient both DC, curious both DC, independent cat, well groomed cat, aloof cat, watchful dog, wise, both are wise so DC, graceful cat, mysterious cat, playful both DC, clean cat, lazy dog, faithful dog. Okay, so that was my opinion. You can write your thought या जो भी आपको लगता है कि ये quality एक dog में होती है या एक cat में होती है, so you can write your own opinion. So this is your homework. You have to write your question answers in your fair notebook, and also you have to do this word power. Okay, submit your homework by 3 o'clock tomorrow. Thank you for watching this video.